Very first section, what is a ledger? So a blockchain is a distributed decentralized ledger. So in this section, we will explain what a ledger is. But before we start explaining what a ledger is, you need to know the importance of a ledger. So every time a society changes or every time a ledger changes, society tends to change with it. So not only does blockchain offer a new way to record transactions, as we will later on show you, it is also a huge societal impact, which makes it a very interesting time in human history, because we are at a tipping point of a possible new society. So blockchain basically is a trust tool, and it records transactions because it records transactions in a different way. So of course, you need to understand this by understanding what a ledger is, and that we will do in the very next slide. So, what is a ledger? A ledger, in short, is a tool to record transactions. So it's a tool we humans use to record transactions. But what are transactions? Transactions are nothing more than activities where people exchange value. So exchange means that it goes from one person to the other person, and value can basically mean anything as long as we deem it valuable. So value often represented as money, for example, but value can also be a house. So a ledger is a tool, and a tool can be a book, for example, but it can also be a database, and it used to be a clay tablet in the very, very long history of ledgers, which we use to record the transfer of this value. So we've got a tool, in this case, for example, a book, which we use to record transactions. So imagine an empty book in front of you, just an entirely empty book in front of you, which you're going to use to record transactions. So what kind of transactions? You can imagine the following example, for example, of this, is just imagine that you're in an empty room. And all of a sudden, 10 of your best friends pop up in the middle of that empty room. What are they doing? They're standing a bit awkwardly. So you're stepping at the sidelines, and you're just going to watch your 10 friends in the middle of the room. And all of a sudden, you will drop a bag of $100 in the middle of it, and they will start dividing it equally. Since they are all friends among themselves as well, everybody will get $10. And that's where you start kicking in, because you, from the sidelines, with your book, starts recording. So the first moment you start recording the names, the identities of your friends in your book, in your ledger, and behind that name you will note down $10 per person, right? So you've got friend A, friend B, friend C, and they all have got $10. Now all of a sudden they start exchanging these dollars. So for example, can you pat me on my back? I have an itch there. Yeah, sure, but it will cost you a dollar. Okay, so I will scratch your back, I will give you a dollar. So the back scratching, of course, isn't recorded, but the switching of the dollar from friend B to friend D, in this case, needs to be recorded. Not only does it go physical from hand to hand, so somebody now has, or friend D has $11, friend B has $9, you also need to record this in the ledger. So you are in the sidelines witnessing the transaction. So you record minus one at friend D or B, I don't know, friend D in this case, and plus one at friend B. So the ledger in this case is the tool that you use to record the transfer of value, right? And value in this example are dollars, but it can be many things. So think, for example, two main categories: tangible assets and intangible assets. So tangible assets are things that you can actually touch, and intangible assets are things you can't touch. So an example of a tangible assets are cash money. So for example, a banknote over here, a car, a house, things that you can actually touch. And intangible assets, another example, is also money, but not this type of money, money on your bank account, which is only available in the digital ledgers of banks, right? Another example are, for example, copyrights or a right to read an online book, stuff like that, right? So they only exist in the ledgers. The intangible assets only exist in these kinds of ledgers. Let me check for a second. Did we cover all the things? Yeah, important here is that these ledgers are tools to record economic activities / transactions / the transfer of value. And the ledger can take different forms, like for example, a book, a database, or a clay tablet, whatever you deem fit to record the transactions. Let me check. Yeah, that's a wrap for now. See you in the next one where we explain why ledgers have an important role.